Due to the length of the previous program, we now join the following program already in progress.
With that three a second ago.
What you got to do, just, you know, you can't be a mental midget in situations like that. I'm sure he's embarrassed, and you got to live with that. And the best way to get that off your mind is to come out and play hard.
Still time here for St. Joe's. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Robinson trying to make something happen. Trapped. And another one from Charlie Brown.
Maybe that's the formula. Sometimes, you never know how things work.
There he is, Charlie Brown. 6 points. Coming in a couple minutes ago.
I love coaching. You never know. Now, all of a sudden he comes off the bench and makes two threes. I mean, it's amazing. We always think we got it figured out, Jeff. That's why I'm over here with you right now.
Good defense underneath by St. Joe's. Nice pass. And the finish. 8-0 run for St. Joe's.
Coach Neubauer not calling the timeout, just rolling with it, keeping his team composed. St. Louis crowd is getting into the game. They need to get a basket here.
Shot clock down to 9.
St. Louis just had that lane packed. How about that block?
2 threes, now a block. Extra step, apparently. So the travel violation on Charlie Brown. Will give it back to Fordham when we come back. St. Joe's is on a run right now. 8-0. It's the Patriots.
Unbelievable.
I don't think you can bet against them. Although John Cook, our producer, huge Falcons fan, so better be careful.
You know what? I better be careful. I want John to make me look good, so because I'm definitely going for the Patriots.
John. Right away, Fordham going underneath. Slanina is able to get the bounce. And a 30-second timeout for Fordham. Tonight here on the American Sports Network, after our game, 8 p.m. Eastern, we'll have Conference USA action. How about Middle Tennessee, the Blue Raiders, 10-0. And they'll put that perfect record on the line. Take it on UTEP as they face the Miners. That's coming up next right here on ASN. Make sure you check your local listings.
Hey, I just did UTEP the other night. They played UAB. Phenomenal coaching job by Coach Tim Floyd and beating UAB, who everyone thinks, or most people think, other than Middle Tennessee. And I got Charlie Brown. Oh, my goodness. Listen, come off the bench the rest of the year, Jeff. Come on.
Hey, some guys, I'm sure you knew some that were better like that.
I'm telling you. I'm telling you, coaching, you never know when you find a gym. You always think we got it figured out. And there's my man with three threes. Now, he's actually 3 points, so don't get me you know, started with that. But he's pretty good with 3 for 3 right now. He'll take it.
Good dish underneath. Better block, though, but out of bounds. It's going to stay with St. Joe's. So Charlie Brown now with 9 points on 3 threes after not starting this ball game. Also had a block on the defensive end.
Great name, right? Charlie Brown. How about the kid being that? That's amazing. You can't make that. That's just great television. You can't make that up.
Well, the good thing is for St. Joe's fans, he's just a freshman. And you know that student section is going to be filled with Charlie Brown jerseys.
No question.
Here in the next few years.
You know what's going through my mind. Who's your favorite character? Come on. My guy was Pick Panther. I love Pick Panther.
See, I like Woodstock.
You like Woodstock?
Yeah, you know, he's sneaky. He's sneaky. Always up to no good. I like Woodstock. You never knew where Woodstock was going to come from.
You're right about that. You see the student section all wearing blue, like you said. Sooner or later, they're going to be wearing something.
Yeah.
Maybe they're wearing Snoopy costumes.
It'll
talk about
Phoenix
that.
Gang.
There you go. The Phoenix gang. That's a good one.
And a turnover. And trying to take it all the way to the other end was Demery as he is fouled.
Good start to the game by St. Joe's. Ten and some change. They've outplayed Fordham thus far. Again, as I said before at the beginning of the telecast, it's about being the best team you can be by the end of the year. St. Joe's a young team. They will continue to progress as the year goes on.
Well, again, these are two teams coming off a loss, and both teams 3-6 in conference play. And we'll get more in-depth in the standings later. There are 14 teams, obviously, in the A-10. The top four actually get a double bye. So if you're in the top four, you're through to the quarters immediately. No. That bottom four, though, Chris, is tough. It's like the old Big East. I mean, you got to win 5 games in 5 days.
Yeah, no question about it. As Mr. Clover checks back into the game. And that is really tough, but I actually like that. Hey, I'm the guy that believes, and I might be in the minority, that if you win your league, it's automatically the NCAA tournament. Some people don't like that. I'm not against conference tournaments. But, again, you want to make sure the guys that you reward the teams at the top. Double bye, single bye, they should be rewarded.
Well, the good thing is with the A-10, too, with those top four teams, it really rewards your regular season performance.
It does. It does. And shout out to the A-10 for doing it that way. And you want your best team's representative of you. I mean, you want March Madness, but you also don't want March Sadness, where a team that's supposed to be there doesn't get there and represent your league.
Demery.
Too wide open there. Fordham does so well. They play those passing lanes. Demery was like, I'm so wide open. What should I do? How about shoot it?
Foul's going to go against Clover for St. Joe's. No, probably a good foul because Fordham had 3-on-1 coming back the other way.
They just create so much havoc. Demery, take a seat there and take a breath. Yeah, coaches always sub at the tournaments. I never understood that. You know, maybe he's tired. Yeah, it's a mental game.
Spoken like a true player. Slanina, she's drawing out the three.
There's a saying, once a player, always a player, never not a player.
Right. You can just hear it in your voice, but perhaps that might have happened to you at one point going over.
Coach Massimino, hey, by the way, 800 wins should be in the Hall of Fame. I can't wait till that happens. Everybody needs to get on board with that for sure. How about that?
Yeah. And that was much needed. A 13-2 run by St. Joe's, but Slanina gets the three, and Fordham wants another timeout, just trying to hang in there. Yeah, you'll see somebody who's a 40-something percent free throw shooter, you know, 48,
yeah.
And not much less from three-point range.
That's crazy.
A 10 action. Dayton, a big winner earlier today. Also, Richmond. Oh, Richmond hanging tight in the standings. LaSalle and George Mason later on tonight. VCU, a 2-point win on the road in overtime.
Mark Schmidt, look at this. Almost got VCU. Look, that game's still going on. VCU up 2. Some bunny hops there.
Foul on Fordham underneath. Yeah. All right, Chris, that game is still in action.
Right.
We'll get you that one when it goes final, but a tight one in overtime.
Tough place to play at St. Bonaventure. You have that little small gym real quaint.
Yeah.
They love it. Coach Schmidt loves it. I know Will Wade's got his hands full right now.
You know, I've heard more coaches this year talk about how difficult it is to play on the road here in the A-10. Like you're talking about some of these venues.
I worked for Steve Lapis when we were at UMass. It was very tough. As a matter of fact, that's when St. Joe's had Jameer Nelson. Jameer Nelson was here.
Sure.
I'm going to say Delonte West. I mean, they were really, really good. And Phil was rolling. He had them rolling back then. I want to say they were almost, top 5 in the country. Or maybe even number 1 back then.
Well, yeah, they were number one. That was the year they finished 30-2.
Yeah, that was amazing.
They lost... fairly early in the NCAA tournament, kind of a disappointing end of the season, if I remember right. But I can't remember. Things like that. I look back on it, but I know that was actually made it to the Elite Eight.
They did. They made the Elite Eight, too. Tremendous. I mean, Phil has done such a tremendous job here. You know, you look at the gym, you know, you're not playing at a 15,000-seat arena, but you got Philly, you know, and he's done a great job recruiting and locating talent. Tough injury this year, lost his best player, and they're just working through it.
Oh, staying with it as Owens underneath and gets the dunk. Yeah, you know, I was just looking back. Chris, I can't believe it. That team that we were just talking about, that was back in 2003 and 2004.
It was a long time ago.
It doesn't seem like it was that long ago.
It doesn't. When you watch Jameer Nelson, those are the two guys who went on to have great careers in the NBA. Still to show you what can be accomplished at St. Joe's and the Atlantic 10. They've been in the Atlantic 10 for a very long time as well, and they've done a great thing. We just hated coming to Philly to play these guys. You just knew they was going to put a 20 spot on you. They were so good. And he's got some young talent now, so watch out for St. Joe's in the future for sure.
Well, what was once a 10-point game is now down to 4. We'll run here for Fordham with 8.5 to play. Kimball dumps it to the baseline. Casper no good. Rebound down to the rim.
So they put so much pressure on you. They speed you up. And they didn't give you one shot. And they're coming at you on the other end.
Hawkins thought about the long three. Senkfelder had an earlier three. He's fired on this one.
Okay, good drive and kick. Get into the teeth of the defense. Making the extra pass. Senkfelder can't knock it down, though. Got to get you, Jeff. The W. They're denying every pass. They're going to make you throw back real fast. They're going to force you to make plays with your head. It's not that easy. And they're coming at you in conversion like they are, but they'll take it right there, though.
Good finish by Jai Williams, the junior. They're from Philadelphia. And he'll have a free throw opportunity when we come back. 7:42 left to play in the first half. St. Joe's with the lead. Nice pass underneath on the finish.
Shirt on and the blue out.
That's got to be a little bit of workout, isn't it?
It looks like he gets a one-arm. He gets a one-armer in there at times. I'm going to catch him with my side. I'm a peripheral. I'm going to keep an eye on him and make sure. Yeah. Keep him honest.
Yeah, we saw him sneaking some water. You're right.
Thought he snuck a one eye. I'm one arm. I'm like, hey, man, I've never seen a Hawk fly one wing, man. Come on now. Keep him honest.
Coming up on 7.5 to play, 24-17. Well, for Fordham, Chris, they're really taking advantage. That's about the only bad news right now for St. Joe's. 8 turnovers have led to 11 of Fordham's 17 points.
It is, and that's the way they have to score. It's just having a tough time. St. Joe's did a good job on the interior and keeping it bottled up and forcing you to shoot from the perimeter.
Here's Casper up top. Of it. Really good defense by the Rams all over.
And they're just dogging you, as we would say. And you have to make a play the way Casper did last time out. And look what happens right there. On the pass lane. Now you see why Chartouni gets so many steals. He's great at anticipating.
Thought about the long three. Chartouni's fairly quiet so far in this one. Remember, he picked up a couple early fouls at the start.
And a heady ball player, very smart. See the way he handles the basketball.
He was short there.
Yeah, he was short.
Soft touch. Couldn't quite get the roll.
They're just trapping. You get in a tough spot. They're forcing you to make plays.
John Williams. 6'9". They have him listed at 240. He's a big kid. He might be a little bit more than 240. Just a big, strong center for St. Joe's.
Yeah, he looks like one of those dudes that play on Saturdays and Sundays, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Nice little pass there. Big fella, take your time, gather yourself, and go straight up and try to get the and one. Just a tad bit out of control, but he did draw the foul.
Foul was on Chuba Owens. It was a second. Tavares now back in the lineup for Fordham. Some changes for St. Joe's as well. Charlie Brown stays in. And Charlie did not start, but responded by hitting three threes and hit a block.
As I look around, Jeff, and what gets me excited when I think about college basketball, as a big fella knocks down another free throw, look at the crowd still supporting the team.
Yes.
And then really coming out, that shows you the pride that they have in the program and what Coach Marcelli has built here. And, you know, at any point, things can turn, especially when they continue to have support.
Well said. Jai Williams commits the fouls. He was trying to hedge out up top.
Get something easier. Everything's been a struggle. It's very tough for them to score a basket. At least I'm going to the rim.
Missing a foul. Trapped in the corner. And calls a timeout. So Fordham going through their timeouts here in the first half. That's their third called timeout of the half.
And here's the bottom line is, Coach Neubauer was calling them early. Like,
right now, top 35 RPI in the country.
And don't forget about Rhode Island. Rhode Island, you know, Coach Bob Hurley. I'm sorry, not Bob Hurley, but with Danny Hurley. Don't count them out. They were thought to be the favorite to start the year. Haven't quite worked out that way, but they're still within striking distance. 9-10 is always a tough out in the NCAA tournament. We'll see what happens as the weeks pass by.
Just as the shot clock expired, no good by Sinkfelder. Wayne, you're right, Chris. It's just been a struggle offensively for the Rams, hasn't it?
It has, and what you have to do in that situation, good job, good block there. But you have to move the defense around from side to side, get a shot fake, and drive the basketball to the rim.
Hawkins,
like that,
listening to you, yes. Drives, couldn't get it to fall. Right on cue, though.
All else fails, get to the rim, put the onus on the referees to blow the whistle. Oftentimes not, you can get a foul and get to the foul line, stop the clock, and see if you knock down two. How about an interesting discussion? What's harder to make, a free throw or a six-foot putt?
Oh, that's a good one. Both for me.
I'll give you my answer in a little bit.
All right, 3 points for Hawkins now. A little bit of a slow start for Javonte. He's averaging 14 points per game. Talked about him in the open. He's the grad transfer from Eastern Kentucky. Has scored over 1,000 points now his career. Started at South Florida, went to Eastern Kentucky, and now playing here with the Rams.
They're so active with their hands on defense. Really love the energy. If they can only duplicate that on the other end, it can get them to the rim and create easier shots. It would serve them well.
By the way, that last shot that was missed by Charlie Brown was his first miss of the night. Hawkins with a three. So Fordham, Chris, getting some timely threes to try and stay in this one now, 4-point game.
I mean, you know, on the road, it's called getting an ugly road win. That's what you love. You love it being dirty and nasty. And you just find a way to chip away at Cole. And now it's a 4-point game. Hawkins, I like Hawkins stepping up and just being aggressive for his teams, particularly when they're struggling to score.
Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Chartouni. So St. Joe's will keep it. 18 seconds in the shot clock. Javon Bauman into the game, senior from Germany. Gives him some more size, 6'8", 255, banging down low.
A lot of international flavor in this game. Look, they hit every single, but they get their hands on everything.
Well, the turnover by St. Joe's.
The finish.
And Chartouni with the finish.
Just did a good job of cutting the body off and using the rim. Couldn't really block the shot. Experience play by the rookie of the year last year in the Atlantic 10.
And look here.
The first part of the NCAA tournament there. I mean, it is a tremendous fan base. And he is doing an exceptional job. The job has traditionally been a good job. But he's definitely taking it to another level for sure.
Chartouni hits the free throw, and that makes it an 8-0 run. Now for Fordham.
I might have been somewhat critical of Coach Neubauer calling the timeouts, extinguishing the way they did, but you know what? There's a method to the madness, and now it's a 1-point deficit for the Rams.
Well, I guess the word that comes to mind for me is doing a good job of managing.
Yes.
The first half.
Particularly being on the road. Don't want it to get out of hand.
Yeah.
As you can see, Fordham just so aggressive defensively. Sometimes that's going to result in some fouls. The Hawks will have to go to the line and punish them for being so aggressive.
That foul on... was it? Yeah, I think the foul was on... Was it Jai Williams?
It was a trap situation.
We'll check on the foul. No, it couldn't have been Jai. He's on the bench. Check who the foul was. There are a couple of guys with a little bit of foul trouble here in the first half. Williams for St. Joe's, who has two. Lamina has three, actually, four. Steals. It was knocked away by Kimball.
And just missed the lane with that pick and pop action with the trap. It's wide open. That could knock it down. That shot's going to be there.
They've used the three to really try and keep themselves in it here so far. Casper fakes the three. I think everyone in the building thought he was going to take it.
Yeah, the recovery time of Fordham, their technique defensively is exceptional.
Campbell, nice touch on the two-pointer.
That's called good defense, better offense. Campbell dribbling into a sweet spot and just shooting over Sartouni. Gifted score. Going to have a big-time future and score a lot of points.
Just a sophomore, another local Philly kid. He has 6 points.
Philly's such a great place for basketball. There are kids all over the place. You got the Philadelphia Big Five. Coach Neubauer, of course, playing at LaSalle. A lot of history here.
Singfelder might have been held inside. Yeah, there's going to be a foul. Actually, no, it's going to go against Fordham. We're going to head back the other way here. Basketball for St. Joe's.
Love the aggression, though. You know, love the aggression. Got to do a better job of tagging and pursuing the basketball and boxing out. But Fordham, if they want to win this game, they're going to have to snatch it, right? Snatch this victory from St. Joe's. St. Joe's not going to give it to them. They both need one right now, Jeff.
Foul was on Javonte Hawkins for Fordham. That was his second. So free throws here on the other end for Charlie Brown. Really good free throw shooter. 86%. 43 of 50 on the season coming into today. And he now has 10 points.
And he's another kid that's going to have a big-time future here. Future looks bright, you know. Again, talking to Coach Mark Bass and talking to Coach Jeff Arnold before the game. Two guys who I think will be head coaches very soon, long overdue. They've been helping Phil Martelli here forever. Put a good program together. That's a great recruiting job. Charlie Brown.
11 points now for Charlie Brown has helped St. Joe's get that lead back. It was down to one a minute ago.
I thought there was some happy feet. Good pass. He says he's so smart. He just makes the right play. Look, he's not a great athlete. He doesn't have to be, right? Most great players from the head up is where they beat you, mental.
A lot of his body placement too, right? Just using your body, just using what size you have.
But some of that's what's smart is being at the right place at the right time. It's not always athleticism. It's just being a smart basketball player and prudent with your movements.
I think that went off the foot, perhaps, of Anderson. And it did, so St. Joe's is going to keep it. 150 to play.
See, Sartouni driving, dropping the dime right there. You see the rotation. Nick Robinson, the freshman, not getting there in time. And they even helping uphill. Casper coming up. Brendan Casper, number 20. You got to stunt. You got to fake at him and force him to make the floater and not just come up and let him drop that, what they call the habit pass, right behind you for the easy deuce.
Clover with plenty of time. He's going to pull up. A little too strong. Charlie Brown's tip won't go, but staying with it is Nick Robinson to tip it in. He has 4 points here tonight.
Those good-looking kids. He's got up to a seven-point lead again. It was at one. Fordham wants to make sure they get a couple of good possessions here going into halftime.
Skip pass to Singfelder. Way too strong.
Wide open shot is what you want. That's playing, sharing the basketball, playing the game the right way. He's got to knock down the basket.
Yeah, he's your guy. I mean, 55 threes on the year.
Yeah, 21 points last game out. I mean, just got to knock that down.
Another turnover. No, actually a foul instead. It's going to go on Bauman. And gives the ball back to Fordham with just under a minute left to play.
Fordham needs to dig in right here. Get a great stop. Hopefully get some transition. Be nice to get a three going into halftime. Cut this deficit down. At least one more score to have some confidence coming back for the second half.
I just got a tweet, by the way, from Monica McNutt. We'll send it down to West Palm Beach in Florida
really?
For the halftime. Yeah, Monica and Tim Scarborough standing by, so we'll hear from them soon.
It's only 30 here. I mean, you're going to tease me like that? Monica and Tim kicking it, and you and I sitting here with our coats on and our gloves. Basketball weather, though, Jeff. We're in basketball weather.
Sartouni.
Good job.
Three, another big one for Fordham. Slanina hits another. He has 8 points.
He's been a playmaker, making plays for his teammates. And Coach Martell is going to get a timeout to talk about this last possession. He's not happy with somebody right now.
Yeah, not pleased at all. And just to update you on that one, Chris, Fordham with 17 points off turnovers.
That's how they win. I mean, that's how they play. That's the way that they really come after you and make things happen for their team.
About 2 seconds difference between the game clock and the shot clock here for St. Joe's.
They're running at you, trying to make you hurry.
Last touch by Fordham. St. Joe's will keep it. Now they got a chance here at the final shot with 7.6 left. Actually, I think they might look at this one again just to make sure. I thought it hit the rim. Didn't it? Yeah, it hit the rim. So turn off the shot clock. 7.6 left.
Official Tony Crisp just gave Coach Martelli a warning, a bench warning, and to chill out a little bit. See, they're coming in double room to create havoc.
1 second left. Kimball just has a bounce off the rim.
Looked like there's a foul there.
You are right, Chris. Yeah, we got a foul as they head over to the scores table. Coach Martelli's headed off the court, but
he's getting some silent jabs in. He's coming off. He's not happy. He is certainly perturbed.
And the officials are going to look at this one again to see, obviously, the timing of everything.
Yeah, it looked like they called the foul before the horn went up. It was of a bang-bang situation.
St. Joseph's University.
Referee Wally Rotecki was all over it. You'll see it again. See the game clock there in the bottom right hand of the screen. Yeah, he definitely got it off in plenty of time. You can see the top of the screen. Wally Rotecki put that hand up.
Yep, so the foul on the shot, and they're saying two free throws now for Kimball.
And they're going to put 1 second on the clock as well. Always like the monitor. Baseball guys don't like the monitor. I like the monitor. Let's get it right. Let's make sure for the integrity of the game. We got all the technology there, right? Remember tweeting and Facebook and everybody. Don't fight technology. Let's get it right.
That foul was on Hawkins for Fordham, Chris, and that was his third, so a big foul to pick up with 1 second left in the half.
Yeah, you're better off just letting him have the layup and making sure one of your best players doesn't have three fouls. Could be costly down the stretch for the Rams.
Kimball makes one of two. He has 7. It's a 5-point game, 1 second left, and that's going to be well short. Well, so St. Joe's again with a couple of big runs in this first half, but the Rams able to get some timely threes. 5 threes in the first half.
The first 5 minutes, as this coach speak, you always say, how you come out the first 5 minutes will determine the rest of the game.
Speaking of Chartouni, he'll stand right in front of us and inbound here to start the second half. Now for Fordham, it's going to be a tough road to hoe here in the second half. They are 0-10 this season when trailing at the half. And we are back underway here from Hagen Arena on the beautiful campus of St. Joe's, just outside of downtown Philadelphia.
See, I like this action. They're moving the ball from one side before. It looks like it's going to be 3 seconds or a foul. And they're going to go to foul from grabbing from behind. So you got to show them your palms. That's the teaching point. Show them your palms. He's got his hands grabbing. Easy call. They're making Ray Perone work tonight. He's calling a lot of fouls.
Well, and that is a big whistle, Chris. That is now the fourth on Javonte Hawkins.
And he's not taking him out of the game either.
Charlie Brown, 3 threes back in that first half. Skip pass nearly stolen away. And Demery knocks in a 2-pointer.
That's how fragile the game is. A tip ball, a deflection. Could have been a steal going the other way. Except it ends up as a bucket for Demery.
Demery second on the team in scoring. He has 7 now in this game. Just in away here in the second half. Slanina with the drive and score.
Good set play. Fake the handoff. Can't give him the basket. Can't go for the handoff. Keep your body between the offensive player and the basket.
So good game for Slanina. Getting the start for the Rams here tonight.
So they're denying everything. Can't keep your dribble up like Kimball just did. You have to stay solid. The skip pass.
Five, Charlie Brown for number four.
Can't say enough about that kid. He's a freshman. He has a very bright future. Now, you got to learn how to go to, you know, go to tutoring and stuff and make sure he's on time. It hasn't hurt him this game. So you want to make sure he learns his lesson, but he is certainly playing great tonight.
Yeah, in case you missed it, he was not in the starting lineup today. Coach Martelli told us he was late to a tutoring session, so he wasn't going to start. And, you know, so many coaches, you know how it is. It's so stressful. They try to keep everything, you know, close to the vest. They don't want to let you know. He's like, no. He told us exactly what it was.
Yeah, I like that. Nice driving there, making a play. Mike Kimball dropping it down to Demery there. It's a little handoff action. Get into that tough spot because they're going to trap you down there. You can't allow them to make that pass through everyone. You got to keep him in the trap. Easy shot, step in three. But once you have him in a trap, you can't let him what they call split you.
Right. Chris, the shot was good. The three was good. And for Kimball, the tie is the season high with four, but the pass.
Pass by
Kimball.
No question. He was the one that made it happen. That's why you always need a great playmaker, someone who's not afraid to make plays for his teammates.
And he wasn't even looking at him.
He was in a tough spot. Probably the only guy that really looked open. When situations like that arise, it's like hot potato. Who's the first guy that's open? Let me get this thing out of my hands.
9-point lead for St. Joe's. Slanina has been hot. That one a little bit short.
You know, it's tough. It's a small margin of error for Fordham on up. When they have a wide open shot as such, they have to knock it down.
Hawks trying to get a three ball. Can't do it. Chartouni with the rebound. Hawkins and Slanina both on the floor with four fouls for Fordham. Chartouni with the legs.
Try to use his body. Just leaned in, took the contact. Could have been an and one, but more importantly, I said some guys have a knack depth for finishing. As you can see, Fordham, which is probably smart, going back in the zone to protect Slanina and Hawkins. Almost like they're in a matchup, like they showed them zone, right? And then they went man to man, but they're crowding that lane.
5 seconds on the shot clock, and what a huge shot for Kimball. He has nine.
So Kimball says, I don't care what you guys are doing. It's like trying to play defense against Aaron Rodgers. It doesn't matter. He can pick anything apart. Good job there by Kimball, taking his time, not panicking, and knocking down the deuce.
And Sartini has his pass stolen away by Kimball. Oh, step through.
Lost it out of bounds, though.
Defensive pressure there. It's usually Fordham putting on the pressure and getting after. Kimball says, I can do the same thing, too. And sometimes you got to punch the bully, Jeff.
Well, you see the graphic with Hawkins and Slanina, both with four fouls and both making the walk over to the bench for a little while.
Most productive guys on offense. We'll see who picks up the slack with those guys going to the bench. They can never afford to have a drop off as St. Joe's is building that lead more and more.
Long three, way too short. Off Fordham, though, and St. Joe's will keep it as they get a nice bounce. Phil Martelli, 22nd season as head coach.
That's a long time.
Four-time National Coach of the Year. Four-time Philadelphia Big Five Coach of the Year.
Phil's been around a very long time. Even when I played, Phil was around.
That was a long time.
All right, come on. Don't date me now. Come on, Jeff.
Nice fake underneath by Demery. Draws the foul. Fouls again quickly mounting for Fordham. And St. Louis later on tonight out of the A-10. With Chris Walker, I'm Jeff McCarrigan. We've been talking about the A-10. Again, 14 teams in the conference. The top four will get double byes, so obviously those four teams will be sitting good for the A-10 tournament in Pittsburgh. What you want to stay out of, and that's why this game is critical tonight, you want to stay out of that bottom four, because that puts you in a situation to have to win five games in 5 days, which obviously very few teams have done.
Yeah, very tough to do that, to have the mental fortitude to get that done. But how about even at the top, Jeff? In the middle, those middle games are important, that log jam, because you want to get that double bye. So every game is important.
Yeah, if you're in the top four, the double bye right to the quarter. So three games in 3 days and you're done. You're on to the NCAA tournament. For everybody else, it's going to be tough. There's Kimball on the run out. Lost it out of bounds. It's going to stay with St. Joe's.
Fordham never stops giving up, tracking you from behind. You have to have your heads up. Head up at all times. You have to advance to basketball. They're just tracking you down from behind. They're bringing back Salina with four fouls.
Salina and Hawkins both with four. Hawkins still on the bench for now, even.
Mixing their defenses up. There's zone action here.
Kicked out of bounds by Singfelder.
St. Joe's needs to be careful, because once they throw it to that short corner, which is the area between the sideline and the lane line, in the midpoint area, they're going to trap you. Right? So they're looking to create some offense with their defense, so they got to be careful.
10 seconds of the shot clock here for Kimball. Tries to force a pass underneath, out of bounds, and it's going to stay with the Hawks with 6 seconds on the shot clock.
Get something going to the basket, a little screen-to-screen action. Fake like you're going out to them and go right in the middle of the lane.
4 seconds. Demery with three and draws the foul.
It's a terrible foul. Jeff, you never want to foul the jump shooter, Will Tavares. Just stay down, verticality, go straight up, and just make him make a shot. Just discipline.
Two free throws here for Demery. Knocks that one in. St. Joe's was 12 of 20 from the free throw line until that make.
You think about what could happen in Pittsburgh in March. This Fordham team beat BCU. You know, so anything is possible. That's what this league is. And these young freshmen like Charlie Brown and Nick Robinson, they get more and more playing time and more experience. They could upset some guys in the tournament. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens.
10-point game ties the largest lead. Chartouni a little bit long on the three. Well, I agree with you, because the way that Fordham, really the best thing they have going for them is the way that they force turnovers.
Right. And again, neutral site.
Yeah.
Anything can happen. I thought Salina got lucky there and got away with a foul. You see Coach Dubar getting him out right away. Didn't want him to foul.
So Salina out with four fouls, but back in with four fouls is Javonte Hawkins.
And now would go right at him. It's a Chris Pope with the basketball. Drive it and see if he'll foul.
So Joe's the keeper. Coming down to 10. Clover into the lane. Nice slash, but missed it. So now the Rams have an opportunity to make the single digits again.
I mean, it's not pretty the way Fordham plays. You know, they lull you to sleep. And if they can turn you over, that's the thing that they have to do to win games, is score off turnovers and create easier baskets for themselves. It's got to be so frustrating to Coach Mubarak. Somebody please make a basket. The game is called basketball, right? The ball's got to go in the rim in order to get a point. You need someone to make a shot. There's nothing more frustrating when you can't make a basket in this game. A lot of things that are fun in basketball, not made to make a basket, not fun.
Anderson, that's not fun when you're caught in the air and don't know what to do with it. Turns it over. St. Joe's just being patient. 10-point lead. 15 to play. Charlie Brown looking for number 5 in 3-point range, and that one misses. Well, we've talked about St. Joe's or rather Fordham's offense and how difficult it's been. Keep in mind, too, and we touched on this early, Chris, but Shavar Newkirk, the junior from New York City, out for the season with a torn ACL. And for St. Joe's, rather.
Right,
I mean,
he's
been out. And they have struggled without him, but...
I mean, you lose one of your better players, Jeff. Think about this. Your leading scorer.
Yeah.
I don't care what kind of adjustment that you have. You see him there with the knee brace on his leg. I don't care what kind of adjustment you have. It's going to be tough, you know, in any sport. You lose your best hitter. You know, you lose your best anything. You know, for golf, for you, you lose that drive that you got, that amazing drive. It's going to be tough, you know.
He had 20 or more points in a game 8 times. Layup left a little bit too short, but the putback is good by Markell Lodge.
The reason why that happened, again, Kemble getting to the lane, forcing help, making people having to play him, dropping dimes. There's no rebounding. People can't box out and can't tag and rebound, so offensive rebound is at a premium when that's the case.
Fordham trying to find something offensively. Can't get it to fall. Here comes Charlie Brown the other way.
Just a lid on it, point blank bunny.
Yeah, carried it. I was wondering if he was going to get whistled for that, and he did.
Tony Crispas, hey, man, I grew up in the hood, man. I know that play. You're not going to get by me on that one. Don't, you know, can't carry the loaf of bread. They don't call that call that often, though.
Every once in a while, you're right.
In the NBA, that's called dribbling.
Right, yeah. Yeah, going back to that Newkirk injury, too, is the fact that it's just a non-contact play.
Yeah, it's just freak accidents happen like that. And think about the balance of your season is in the midst of that when a kid gets hurt. Who's prepared to deal with that? No one. Very, very few guys can.
We got a timeout. 11:54 left to play. Largest lead of the night for St. Joe's. It's a...
Even George Mason, if they can get on the run, they can get close and get in that top four. So there's a lot of basketball to be played. You mentioned 3 teams getting in. I'm sure the A-10 wants 4, as many as possible. But there is an opportunity, because they're going to keep playing each other, Jeff. And hopefully their RPIs go up and not down.
Well, the RPIs are looking pretty good right now at the top of the conference. Wow. Nearly had the highlight of the night as Markell Lodge going for a highlight reel dunk. Well, looking at the top of the standings as far as the RPI goes, you got Dayton at 30, VCU at 31, Rhode Island at 37. So, you know, if the Bonnies or Richmond, you know, somebody maybe makes a run and surprises everybody, they could get 4 teams in with those RPIs.
Well, they certainly can. And Atlantic 10 has always been competitive in the NCAA. That's what you want. When you start handing out at-large bids, you want to make sure everybody loves that feel-good story of March Madness and the underdogs. But the Atlantic 10, there's no underdog. They play good basketball in this league.
We'll see Lodge active on the boards tonight. 7 rebounds. Knocks in the free throw. Well, so more than likely right now, you know, you look at VCU, Rhode Island, maybe Dayton, or one of the top teams, if they win it. Well, you'd think 3 teams get in, right?
Yeah, no question. I think 3 is a lot for sure. And, again, there's a lot of basketball being played. We'll see as the season winds down who puts himself in a much better position of that middle of the pack.
Nice. Anderson with the 3. He has 6 points. And every time that St. Joe's has made a run, Fordham seems to come back with some timely threes. We'll see if they can do it again.
He dropped a bomb from way deep. They're like, sure, take that one. Mr. Anderson knocks down not 1, not 2, but 3 times. Fordham back in his zone. Shutting down the penetration also for the foul trouble with Hawkins and Salina.
And the bounce last touched by the Rams, so St. Joe's will keep it.
Again, they're trying to offense, defense. Keep these guys like need them on offense. Trying to steal minutes is what Coach Neubauer is doing.
He's been working, isn't he? He's doing the best he can over there.
They call it the Harlem Shuffle right now.
Kimball off the screen. Charlie Brown with the offensive rebound. Charlie's having a big game. A couple of blocks. Good offensive rebound there. 4 threes, which ties the season high.
Job had it for a second. So, two threes out very quickly. I like the defensive principles by Fordham, even though Charlie Brown says, my fifth Cinco.
New season high. Love that kid tonight. I'm telling you, you wait. It won't be long. The student section is going to be decked out in Charlie Brown gear.
You know what? The coach got his attention. How about that? You're talking about the mental preparation of the game. Him not starting may have gotten him right mentally, and that's why he's coming out and having a big game.
5 3-pointers, a new season high for Charlie Brown. 17 points on the night. To cut to the basket, and another foul on the Rams.
Fordham's in the danger zone right now, Jeff. 13-point deficit. Robinson going to the line for two. Could be as many as 15. Got to get some offense. 37 points with less than 10 minutes to go. It's just tough to win. You know, you can't pitch a shutout, right? This is not soccer. You don't have Roger Clemens. And it's just really tough. You don't have guys that can just make things happen offensively.
I remember a long time ago, Jim Valvano said his motto, I mean, comebacks are great, as he well knows, but his motto was always under 10, under 10.
Yeah.
Then you know you got a chance.
No question. No question. But again, under 10, under 10, you got to still get big shots.
Yeah.
You know, you rely on your defense. Two of your better scorers are in foul trouble. You know, it's a small margin of error. We'll see if they can get something done. It's, you know, it's college basketball. As long as that 3-point line's out there, there's plenty of time to come back in this ball game.
Holmes just picked up his fourth. So now three Rams with four fouls. Another 3-pointer as Antoine Anderson knocks it in. He has 9 points.
Yeah, that 3-ball, I tell you, anytime you can knock that 3-ball down, it gets people excited, A. And at the other line, it gives you a chance to come back in this game as you Fordham. Little junk defense here. And they're going to trap those corners. Angel's got to be careful because, again, they need to get themselves going by trapping and getting steals and force them to take shots like that.
Anderson into the corner.
Unbelievable.
And Tavares hits the three. So, again, Fordham using a couple of 3-pointers to get themselves back in this one.
But see, that's what I'm talking about.
The American Sports Network. Make sure you check your local listings. Chris Walker, I'm Jeff McCarriger. Thanks to John Cook, our producer, and our entire ASN crew. Doing a great job as always. Also, our thanks to our statistician here at the court, Tom Bonerbo, working the stats for us.
Tom's on point. He's keeping it straight up.
Tom's making us sound smart tonight.
Yes, he is.
That's not easy to do, trust me.
Certainly not me, for sure.
Hey, we can take him with us tomorrow across the road.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't it great being up here in Philadelphia this weekend?
Oh, man.
What a big weekend of hoops.
Fun time. We're missing the Super Bowl. I'm from Houston. That's all right, though. Oh, nice shot there.
St. Joe's answers. Demery knocks it in. He has 11 points.
Always good when you come out of a timeout. Coach drawing up the play. You get a bucket. Kind of calm them down because Fordham was on a little bit of a run.
Anderson thought about the three, well guarded by Kimball, now dribbles around him. Seinfelder trying to keep it alive. And a collision as Charlie Brown hits the deck.
Anderson upset with himself. Had a point-blank layup. Probably looking at the shot block instead of focusing on the rim and finishing the play. St. Joe lucky there.
Foul was on Charlie. That's his second is on. So Slanina back in the game, as you just saw for Fordham. Again, he has 4 fouls. Anderson, a long three, spins out. A whistle and a foul on St. Joe's underneath. All these little things are keeping Fordham alive. You know, the fouls, the turnovers, a couple of threes by Fordham. Now media timeout with 7:54 left to play.
There he is again, Mr. Demery, picking up where he left off last game, getting a bucket, keeping the Hawks flying. 8 minutes to go, and limit turnovers, they haven't done a great job of that, but it has not hurt them to this point. They still have an 11-point lead.
They have done a little bit better job here in the second half. Remember, they had, 11 turnovers in the first half alone.
They did. I mean, they're starting to, you know, settle down a little bit, but you could see Fordham, as they get a little bit more desperate and the clock starts withering down even more, they're going to get a lot more aggressive. We'll see if they handle that pressure then. Good pass.
Slamina with the finish.
Big fella got to dunk that, Jeff. He got to dunk that. Come on.
Slamina with 12 points.
That's 6'10"?
Yeah, coach will be like, come on, coach. He made the fundamental play. He's got to create a Kodak moment so we can yell and scream over here.
And he's back to single digits.
Fordham back, playing zone. Keep them off balance, keep them on their feet. Hopefully shoot long threes, and it'll create some run-out situations for their fast break.
Charlie Brown looking for number six, but can't get it out of bounds to Fordham. 7 minutes, a lot of time left here still for Fordham.
Plenty of time. You know, the game is broken down into four-minute games. If they could get it with 4 minutes to go and they keep it within 5 points, it's a ball game the rest of the way. Nice try.
Couldn't finish it, but the follow by Anderson.
He is athletic.
11 points now for Anderson.
He's having a good game. I mean, he's asserting himself offensively when, you know, Chartouni's not scoring. And you got Hawkins on the bench. Somebody has to pick that slack up. And Mr. Anderson has certainly done that tonight.
This game is very reminiscent. We had a game the other night in the MAC with Western Michigan and Ohio. Western Michigan was down 21 points in the second half, did the exact same thing that we're watching right now. Just tried to stay within the middle of the run, tried to stay within 7, 8, 9 points, keep it single digits. They ended up winning by 5.
And that's what happens. Some teams, you're talking about the youthfulness of St. Joe's. Playing with the lead, that's what experienced teams do.
Yes.
So it's very hard to play with the lead. You're at home. You know, you want to win. You don't want to make the wrong plays. You're not as aggressive. And then what does Fordham have? Nothing to lose by just going after them, you know? So, but he's got to do what the Hawk is doing. He's got to keep flapping, keep the pressure on. I'm go over there and bring him some water. You think he needs a little water or what?
Well, I haven't.
Can he grab the water during the timeouts?
Well, we caught him on camera earlier, sneaking a little shot of the Gatorade.
He got a little shot of the Gatorade.
Remember we saw him? So he's flying with one arm back in the first half. There he goes.
Yeah, yes. Turn my peripherals off. I'm focusing on the game. And there he's got the one arm. We caught him.
11 points now, by the way, for Kimball. Awesome turnover.
Right there. That's Coach Newbound for the game. Hey, it'll be 9-5 some change. Well, you're down 9. You're in striking distance. He's not going to frown upon that. They just got to make a couple plays down the stretch in that zone. What they force you to do? You can't be afraid. You got to attack the zone. Can't be on your heels, because now they're coming back at you. They can cut this thing to 6. They get a 3-ball.
Oh, Anderson just lost it out of bounds.
Yeah, tough play loss. We had Zelina on the pick and pop action. Jeff Bauer just not flustered tonight, you know, just staying encouraged with his team. He knows this is second year. He knows, you know, the job he's overtaken and he is going to do. How about they have all the international players? You know, international flavor. 4 different countries. Just being creative on how he can get players.
Under 5 minutes left to play. Here's Chartouni.
Chartouni's been relatively quiet tonight, Jeff.
Just 5 points so far tonight, right? Averaging over 11 points per game. Chartouni's got it. Slanina. It's good.
Can I call him or what? 3-ball. Now we're at a 6-point lead. 4-minute game. 4 minute, 35 seconds to go. St. Joe's got to play basketball. Can't be on the hill. See, Fordham is in that zone. I said, I dare you to shoot it. Now the youthfulness of St. Joe's and Charlie Brown, and Kimmel, they got to play now.
They got in the corner. Charlie Brown runs on the baseline. Nice touch.
Such a good one. Playing with poise.
A new career and season high for Charlie Brown. 19 points tonight.
Dare I say the bench has one out tonight.
There he is, looking for three-pointer number six. Got it.
Unbelievable. Look at Charlie Brown there. Got his fan, his number one fan. He's going to wear that shirt every home game.
Never wash it. Foul on St. Joe's. It's going to go against Nick Robinson. Charlie Brown now, 22 points on the night. And the lead is back to
And look at his guy saying, are you serious? I taught him how to do that.
6 3-pointers. And as you see, a new career high for Charlie Brown, who did not start today. Little move by the coach to shake it up after he's a little late to a tutoring session. All right, Fordham not going away yet either. A little hook shot underneath by Sinkfelder.
The call out of bounds, no resistance. You let anybody in college basketball get the ball that close to the basket, it's going to be a problem. Game's still late. They're very much in this game, the Rams. They need a couple of stops.
Well, that's what they've been able to do. They've been able to force turnovers in this one. We'll see if they can get another couple turnovers here down the stretch.
Playing a matchup zone. Get to the end of the shot clock. Got to get the rebound. Don't foul.
We'll force it up.
What you want to do in that defensive possession there? Didn't really kill St. Joe's because they extinguished some time off the clock. But we'll see what Fordham gets done here.
Chartouni rips the three.
And that happened. A slip screen by Slalina. He slipped the screen to cause some confusion between the defenders, and they were not there to get the proper hand up on Chartouni. And we got a 6-point game here with two and some change.
You mentioned it. You know, I don't think a lot of people realize it. You obviously had to deal with it at Villanova, playing with the lead.
It's tough. And when you have young guys, you know, you can't play not to lose. You have to play to win the game.
1 second left. Off the glass and just bounces out. Slanina with the rebound.
Think about the two shots they just got for consecutive possessions. Not great looks. And Fordham's coming right back at you.
Oh, Chris. What a move. Tavares with a jump stop.
Well, a grown man move. He went to the rim, took some contact, and said, hey, the bank's still open tonight.
Tavares with 7 points. The lead is down to 4, and St. Joe's wants a timeout. From the Czech Republic.
Good-looking player, got a bunch of size. He's got to get in the weight room, though, get a couple of, you know, get some tries and buys. But that's what they look like at the next level. You get him some size.
Yep.
Already has a skill set. Put him in that zone. Again, keeping St. Joe's on their heels. St. Joe's will get some in the middle of that lane and try to attack and try to get to the rim. Get some on that baseline action.
The basketball.
The pass.
Wide open with Sinkfelder underneath.
Transition defense, long rebounds. Like I said, that's why you play zone. Can't get back in time. And now we got a ball game.
Under a minute left to play.
Fans are on their feet to see if St. Joe can get something right on Atlantic 10 sign on the screen. See if somebody can flash in there and get some on that baseline or fan out for a shooter.
3 seconds on the shot clock. No good.
Wow.
How about that ball? It's going to go against Chartouni.
I got to see that again. I have to see that again.
That is his fourth.
Lodge went up to the top of the square. He was so high for that rebound. Push a real techie with the call. Yeah, he kind of came under him. Good call. Good call. That's why those guys are professionals. See, I wouldn't have seen that, you know.
Well, you mentioned earlier how much you like replay.
Yes, I do, man. Let's get it. You're right. Let's get it right. Oh, wow.
Huge miss.
Another foul. That's a costly foul. But you know what? They only got three fouls, so.
Trying to ground. That'll be his third. If you are just tuning in, 35 seconds left. We're at Hagen Arena just outside downtown Philly. We're on the campus of St. Joe's. The Hawks had a 15-point lead at one point.
Evaporated very quickly, Jeff. 35 seconds. St. Joe's going to get the ball back if the game is tied. From Fordham, that same type of action, moving the ball from one side to the floor, driving the basketball to the rim. That's what I'd do if I were them.
Martuni to Slanina. And a foul on St. Joe's.
You could see that development, that slip play. They've been running like four or five times now. They're the first time that they hit the slip guy, Slanina.
Coming up after our game, we're going to send you out to Conference USA, Middle Tennessee, 10-0. Taking on the Miners of UTEP. We got a good one here in Philadelphia tonight.
We do. Now think about it. 24 seconds on the clock, 24.2. They can take the last shot, right? Shot clock is in their favor, but they have to make the shot. And there's our guy.
Oh, and Fordham takes the lead.
How about that? Wow. They lulled them to sleep. 1 point lead with 15.5, Jeff.
The last lead for the Rams was. So here are those standings again. That bottom four is tough. Got to get out of there. That's why this game is critical for both teams, both sitting at 3-6.
St. Joe's here. Get something going to the rim. Fordham is committing to staying in the zone. I love to see them. Oh, wow. I love to see them get a ball screen or something. Get the ball in the middle of that zone in the lane.
Kimball to retake the.
You got to take a look at that, the monitor. I think it was a two. Jeff Neubauer takes his jacket off. He's fired up. He's about as fired up as I've seen him this game. Said, give me my board.
As it stands right now, it's a two-point lead as they go to the monitors. Again, this is one of the replay rules they've added in the final 2 minutes of regulation and overtime.
How about Kimball stepping up? I can't get it. Can't get a good look on it. It was contested.
Toes might have been on the line. That's obviously what they're looking at right now. Well, regardless, Chris, whether it's a two or a three, it's going to be St. Joe's with the lead, either by one or by two, with 6.5 seconds left to play.
Man, that was a big-time shot by the sophomore, Mr. Kimball.
Kimball with 14 points, 4 assists on the night.
Gutsy to take that. Let's get a look right here and see if his toes, nice and slow. Oh, wow. Anderson's in the way. You can't see it. His leg is right there.
Well, that's going to be tough, Chris, isn't it?
It's going to be tough.
I don't know if there's enough.
You see Jeff Bauer, Blue Bauer over there drawing up a play like a mad scientist. Let's see if we get another look here. Man, it is really tough. You know what? It looks like, man, it's just really hard to tell.
Right there is about your best look.
Look at that shadow.
Right there. They're trying to see if they can stop it, and it's tough.
Look, let me see. It looked like a game of three.
Right there, they're saying it is behind the line, so it is a three-pointer for Kimball. And they are going to put some more time back on the clock, though. 7.2 seconds on the clock here for Fordham, down by two.
Plenty of time if you're Fordham. Hey, you go for the three and go for the win and get out of here. Get the drive. It always happens. You get everybody converged on them. Kick it. You got Segler in the corner. Seckfeld in the corner, 4-3. You got your guy Hawkins in the other side. So that spreads the floor.
Yep.
And then you also have a ball screen pop back for Selena, who's made a couple threes. So we'll see how St. Joe's tries to defend it.
Well, the three has definitely been a big play for Fordham. 11 threes for the Rams tonight. And here we go. 7.2 left. Anderson foul.
Yeah, they had a foul to give. Got one more to give. Good smart play by the staff. So the assistant coaches alerted. Coach Martell, he's got a veteran staff there. His three assistants have been with him for a long time. Now, again, now they have to play because they can't foul here.
And Fordham wants a timeout, talk things over again.
That's what coaches love right now. They love the opportunity to sit here and draw up that play they've been dreaming about, laying in the bed when they were a kid. You know, the big-time players, when they were kids, they think about making the zone and switching the flow of the game, and it benefited this team. But right now, we'll see what he's hooked up for his squad to try to steal this game.
Sartouni to inbound. Sartouni's got it. 2 seconds, drives, and scores with 1 second left.
How about that?
Kimball blocked, and we are headed to overtime.
Give and go action. Elite play calling right there by Jeff Neubauer. Man, I love this game.
Again, coming up next after this one, we'll send you out to Conference USA, Middle Tennessee, 10-0 to take on the Miners of Utah. But first, overtime here.
Fordham still in that zone. Hey, keep in mind foul trouble, Jeff. Remember, Hawkins has four, Salina has four. Hawks have just been on their heels. There it is. That's what I want right there. Get to the middle of the lane. Oh, come on.
Sanina just picked up his fifth, Chris.
I don't know about that one. I thought he just had his hand straight up. That was
that
a tough call.
For Sanina. Gosh, what, 22 seconds in?
Yeah.
And he's out for the rest of the overtime.
Drive it to the rim. Out of control, spinning out again. You know what? Came down. Good call by the refs. I'll take that back.
Well, and you see that with the refs all the time. When you're watching the games live, they'll tell you, you know, they'll motion with their hands downward if they went straight up. And that's exactly what happened. So his hands came down.
Wasn't a lot of contact. Henry goes, it wasn't a lot of contact. Man. That's why these guys are elite at what they do. You know, I would never want to be a ref, by the way. But they do such a great job, you know. As Will... This is Wally with Techie Kelwood told me, he says, hey, it was a three, man.
Well, free throws have not been friendly for St. Joe's tonight. 18 of 32.
Wow. They're going to be in the gym. I guarantee you one thing for sure, they will be doing that. That is just a lack of concentration. If they lose this game, that will certainly be the contributing factor, not making the freebies.
Tooney has it poked away. And they're going to say Ram basketball.
Jeff Neubauer saying, hey, you called it on one end. Let's get the same call on this end. Got to get up quick.
1 second left. Anderson for the lead, and it's too strong.
They go try to score quickly before the zone sets up. Look for that same action with the Atlantic team sign and see if they can get into the teeth of that zone and make plays down to the basket.
Kimball tried to feel out that zone and can't find a gap in it yet. Too strong by Charlie Brown. And now St. Joe's will keep it and still plenty of time on the shot clock.
He's struggling against his own, Jeff. St. Joe's really haven't had an answer. That's what Fordham has done to get themselves back into the game and get this game in overtime. But St. Joe's need to try to figure something out very quickly. I'd like to see them get it in that paint area and get the zone to converge and either fan out 4-3 or get something going to the rim, which got played in his last foul.
Possession. Damery, a strong drive and a foul underneath Fordham as it looks like Holmes is down and injured.
Looked like he came down on his elbow. How about this? We get Kimball in a tough spot. He has nowhere to go. goes for a shot fake. Same Curtis goes for a shot fake. He just stays down.
Owens just picked up his fifth, so now he's out of the game. And Demery headed to the free throw line. And we were just talking about this, Chris. We'll see if the Hawks can get a couple of free throws here.
Yeah, that's the one place that you would hate to lose a game. But I did pose the question to you earlier. Is it 6 foot putt harder or the free throws?
I think we found our answer.
Yes, we did.
And he's now 5 of 13 from the free throw line, Demery is.
Lonzo looks like he can still be in a little bit of pain, but Fordham needs to box out. Can't afford to allow St. Joe's, if there's a miss, to come over and get an offensive rebound. Wow, two misses. How about that, Jack?
Man. Still tied at 64. Nice move by Anderson. Step back. Too short.
Tough shot.
Kimball quickly ahead. Offensive foul. We're going to go back the other way.
Out of control. Good job there by Sinkfelder stepping in and taking the charge. Can't leave your feet with nowhere to go. He's coming, pushing the ball with his head up, which I love. Before that zone sets up, sit there waiting for him. He had a lunch, you know, had a hanging out with his girlfriend before he got there.
He was hanging out with Hilarious cheesesteak in his hand. Chartuni thought about it.
Good play. Good shot. So smart. Giving no action. That's why you need a guy like him on your team. Not a dunker, not an athlete, but a guy who wins from the neck up.
Rams take just their third lead of the night.
There's no answer for the zone.
Yeah, the zone has changed everything tonight.
Got a pass fake, misdirect. Can't throw in the same direction. There it is right there. That's what we're looking for. We got to make it, though.
Fordham now with a chance to extend their lead. This run now extends back to a 16-3 run for the Rams.
Fordham's going to run some clock, a little triple drive action. Oh, great block.
Chartuni gets it back, though. 15 seconds on the shot clock, under two to play.
See if they get that same slip action on that ball screen. There it is.
Off the mark. Offensive rebound by Anderson. And a foul on the Hawks underneath.
See, that's just a tough play. Anderson's fading back into the shot clock. Just go straight up. Don't foul and don't bail him out. He's played well. Anderson's played well.
Fordham just 5 of 6 from the free throw line. And make it 6 of 7. So we got St. Joe's 18 of 33. And for Fordham, 6 of 7.
A give and go. Just smart. Making the right play. That's why he was the rookie of the year. Throwback player, Jeff. But 4-point deficit here by St. Joe's. In overtime, who would have thunk that they'd be in this situation right now? Fordham has certainly stymied them with this zone. It's kind of a matchup, but they're doing a great job passing people off. Somebody's got to step up and make a basket.
Kimball turns it over. 3-on-2 for Fordham, and they throw it away.
Barsha just kept at it going through. No one was there. There was no resistance to take a charge. Just go straight up, force the ref, put the onus on them to blow the whistle. That could be crucial there, not scoring or converting there.
1:20 left here in overtime. And a steal. Jai Williams.
Have a time.
Actually, make it to Hawkins with the jam.
Talk about the 8 turnovers that Kimball had the first time, starting to play them.
That was a big 3 on the other end. Clover answers for St. Joe's. So Hawkins with the dunk. St. Joe's gets a 3 by Clover. And a 3-point game with under a minute left to play.
PetProject.org.
.5 seconds left here in overtime. Rams on the road with a three-point lead. Chartouni just does get it in to Anderson.
Plenty of time. Don't want to foul him for sure. They've got good players on the floor that can make free throws.
Chartouni trying to get Anderson back door. Had him, but first a foul. And it's on Kimball. His second. So free throws, again, a huge story in this one. Back to the line go the Rams. 7 of 8 from the free throw line.
And more importantly, they have really good foul shooters in the game. They all shoot 73, 75. They're all above 70 to 80 every guy on the floor now. So it's really not an option to foul here.
Makes them both. It's a five-point lead, largest lead for Fordham.
Man, how about that tail of two halves? 15 free throws, St. Louis missed. They got to get something quick. Move the ball quick, get in the lane, and kick for three. The pass.
Wow. It bounced on the rim and falls in.
But Jeff, that's what I was talking about the entire game. Where did that shot come from? In the lane. You got to get in the lane. You can't pass it around the horn or around the perimeter. Get them trapping.
Demery just looking at it. Please go in.
It's still a game.
Yeah, still plenty of time. 32.3 in college basketball is forever.
But what they're going to have to do is they're going to have to press. They're going to have some full court pressure. There's a 2.3 second differential. So they're going to have to extend. I would trap, right? Try to see if I can get two traps before I'd foul. You know, that's plenty of time to do that. And maybe they'll turn it over.
Substitution into the game for the first time tonight is Sabine Hafsa, the freshman. For Demery. A three-point play makes it a two-point game. And Tavares gets fouled right away.
See, I don't know if I would foul. I would try to trap. I mean, Coach is a big-time coach. He knows exactly what he's doing, how he wants to handle the situation. I would trap first because they may throw it away instead of giving them a chance to score points and increase the lead.
Chris just saw a shot of Chartouni on the bench a second ago. It's another member of the Rams on the bench, fouling out with five right next to Slanina.
You tell Jeff Neubauer he wins this game with three guys fouling out. I'm going to tell you, it's two words. I gave it to you earlier. It's called party bus. Back to the NYC.
There's Coach Neubauer.
Man, I love this league. Great basketball. How about that? Ice water.
So Tavares with 8 points makes the lead three, and this one obviously critical. We'll try to extend it to four.
30 seconds, plenty of time. Even if he makes it, they got a chance to still get a two. Obviously, preferably if they can get a three, that'd be great. So you can foul and still be a one possession game. Still with the, get in the middle of that zone. Got a pass fake. Can't pull those long passes.
Behind and a foul.
And that's his fifth.
Yep, another Ram, the fourth of the night to foul out. And now Neubauer is having to go all the way to the end of the bench.
Just costly foul coming from behind. Even if you thought you got it clean, at this juncture in the game, it's just an easy call. So Ray Perone, veteran official. Now there's four, Jeff. Now think about it. Now we're really talking about a party bus. If you get it done now, man, this game is shaped up to be a exciting battle.
Thomas Sanchez into the game. Robinson in and out. And St. Joe's now 19 of 35 from the free throw line.
I'm going to give credit to Fordham because they did a good job of Coach Neubauer, but they had a lot of help with the foul line. Just lack of concentration and not knocking out foul shots.
Maybe the Miles with a Hawks in it. It's a big one there, though, to make it a three-point game again. Fordham calls Saints. A timeout, 22 seconds left, and again, a three-point game.
The fans were a little bit animated, saying time was coming off the clock. Think about this. Savit hasn't played the whole game, right? You can run the baseline on a made free throw, and he just stood there. So if I'm Coach Martelli, trap whoever gets the ball first. Don't foul. Let's vision with a chance to close it out. That's why I love college basketball.
Fordham's last win in the Philadelphia area was 2008 against Temple. Get it into Tavares. And with 19 seconds left, Brown has to grab him real quick. That's going to be his fourth.
Let's even think about it. He's one of the better free throw shooters. How about go trap him, force him to throw it to Hafsa or Sanchez, and then foul them?
I'm with you.
Yeah.
Maybe you should have coached.
No. I like this seat over here with the producer, John Cook, and hanging out with you. I'm in good company right now. That's why I lost all my hair, Jeff, you know?
Is that right?
I had
a good look for you.
I had a nice quaff before, man, and I start coaching, man. It just start going away.
Fordham, 12 of 13 from the free throw line.
St. Joe's, they're going to be sick if they end up losing this game. Plenty of time.
Four-point game.
Still get a two.
15 seconds left. And that one in to make it a 75-73 game.
Going to trap him. Wow.
Fans, yep, you're right. They thought they tied him up.
Nick Robinson says, what? Who, me? Tony Crisp right on top of it, the official. Not over, Jeff. Still, Tavares just missed one. Still has to go to the line.
Yep. You read my mind. They just missed one a second ago. They have not missed many. They're 12 of 14 from the free throw line.
And he at least has to make one. That way a three-pointer ties the ball game.
Bounces out. How about this?
That six-foot putt's looking real good right now, right?
Too short. It's a two-point game. 9 seconds left. Here's Kimball. In the lane, a whistle and a foul on the Rams. 5.4 seconds left to play.
Free throw shooting is going to be a demise. Think about it. All Tavares has to do is make one free throw.
By the way that St. Joe's has shot free throws tonight, this is not the worst case scenario right now for them.
You're right about that.
Kimball is 3-for-5 from the free throw line. Again, if you're just tuning in, for St. Joe's to the court. And we're going to put 5.4 on there.
Think about this. One more thing to think about if you're Fordham. If he misses, you need to box out and make sure you get the rebound. You don't want to tap in.
Wow. One-point game. Boy, this place is just going dead quiet as the sophomore here from Philadelphia tries to tie the game. Got it. 5.4 left. Fordham still with the chance here in overtime. Sinkfelder, 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Anderson at the buzzer. And we're going to head to a second overtime.
Unbelievable.
So
tonight, he's still waving those
arms. I was going to say, he better be waving those arms. I know he's tired.
He's looking at his watch. Oh, I don't know if he can put a watch on the wing, but at the end of the day, he's earned his pay.
And away we go. Overtime number 2 here from Philadelphia. With Chris Walker and Jeff McCarriger. Thanks to John Cook, our producer, our entire ASN crew. What a game tonight.
Staying in that zone. It's been very successful for him. Then they're inside wide open. They got a ball fake and get it to him. That's where your advantage is. One shot game. That's what you do. Play zone. Hope they shoot. Give them one shot.
Keep an eye on than Charlie Brown maybe in this overtime.
Quiet, remember, career
high 22 points, but quiet in that first overtime.
Yep, you're right. He has been relatively quiet. That zone has, you know, they get credit for him for going zone. It's kind of taken away the different shots that he's gotten.
Anderson, a good look at the three, but too short.
A great hustle.
And saved, I think it was. What a play. Jesse Bunting for Fordham, leaping into the air and throwing it off of a St. Joe's player.
Fans are fired up. Getting a look at that one again. Segfelder. Oh, good play. That's a good play. Good hustle.
Pass to trying to inbound. Segfelder still in the game for the Rams. Leads a team of threes. And Tavares came to a sliding stop. That'll give it back to the Hawks.
Yeah, jump stop pivot is legal, but got the case of the happy feet there.
Well, again, keep your eye on Charlie Brown right now. Markel Lodge just whispered something to him. I don't know if they're going to try and go to Charlie here or not.
Running that baseline. Baseline run. They're going to guard that. They got to get the ball in the middle of the zone and then fan it out to him once they converge. On Demery in the middle, football screen.
Kimball hits a three.
Or you can do it that way.
That works.
Yeah, that works. Yeah, please.
Tavares trying to answer, can't do it. And a foul against St. Joe's underneath. Bunting doing his best to get to it. And Markel Lodge called for the foul.
Well, fans are going to go nuts. Official Ray Perone right on top of it. Looks like Bunting went over the top. And Ray Perone says he's grabbing from the bottom. Got to make two.
Oh, what a big free throw for Jesse Bunting. He's only been there 13 times all year. What a job this guy's done tonight.
Oh, man, he's earned his money tonight. He's earned his money. He's done a good job of bringing guys in and out of the game. Both these coaches have done a really good job. This is an exciting game. Two guys going at it. That's why I keep saying, and you've echoed the same thing, that in Pittsburgh, is anything can happen.
Yeah.
Anything can happen.
There's Phil Martelli, and yeah, what a job he's done with his team. Again, playing without Shavar Newkirk. That's 20 points per game they're playing without.
Sure, yeah, he's playing with a young bunch. That's why they're so excited. They're on City Ave. You're right, Charlie Brown's been quiet. Let's see if they can get it loose here for a triple.
And the floater is blocked.
So he got his extra pass. All he had to do is make one pass. He had two or three guys around him. Make a pass around the horn. Charlie Brown's on the floor wide open.
Fordham with a chance to take the lead here in the second overtime.
We're going to dribble drive.
They're going to say he was touched. So not an over and back violation. 5 seconds.
Good pass.
Segfelder for three. Too strong. Rebound down to St. Joe's.
There he is.
Charlie Brown. Segfelder with the rebound. And the Rams, another opportunity to take the lead. Coming up on 2 minutes left to play. No good. Out of bounds to St. Joe's.
Anderson has knocked down a couple of those threes. Point blank range, wide open. Has not been able to convert. If they run that ball screen up top one more time, you see the four guys are fouled out. It's a monumental win if they can win. But those guys getting out of the game. Almost out. An overtime and a half. So they're switching guys off, passing guys off.
Deep. Kill!
He has come up big at least three times tonight when they beat him. And they've all been threes.
22 points tonight for Kimball. Rams trying to answer. Nice pass and a finish underneath by Bunting.
Hassel says, have some.
dropping a dime. What a game.
Kimball looks over the zone defense that they've been looking at from the second half on.
So right there, it's got a park in there. Got to sit there and park. Kimball was open. That shot is open. Don't leave him, though.
Kimball again. That one a little too strong. And a foul over the back by Martell Lodge.
Yeah, easy call. Martell Lodge not happy, but he was certainly over the back. I mean, this is good for whatever. Got to knock that down. Somebody's got to be there. He's been the one guy that's been hot. And Hapsa says, Hapsa, I'm dropping a dime. Demery there getting there late. Probably caught everybody by surprise that number 15 tried to make a play. He's letting them know, hey, man, I can play too now. Don't get it twisted.
Bunting again on the court, forced into duty here with four players fouled out. He has five and now a chance to tie the game.
Wow, college basketball. How about that? You see the guys on the bench all fired up for those guys. They're probably the scout team guys. But this is where this stuff is invaluable.
Coming up on 30 seconds left to play. The tie game here in Hagen Arena.
Pass making flash is wide open in the middle.
Shot clock down to six.
Trap him down there.
Trapped in the corner. Turnover. Ram for the chance to take the lead. .7 seconds left.
Unbelievable. That's what they do, Jeff. You drive.
Here in double overtime on the campus of St. Joseph's University.
St. Joe's, listen, going to the rim, but no better play. Give it to number zero. Let him put his head down and make a play. And if not, you got Charlie Brown in the corner. 4-triple for the game.
9 seconds left. Kimball with 8 drives. And gets the foul.
See that again. And that was set up to be a charge for sure.
And again, it comes down to free throws. 7.1 seconds left.
We just sitting there waiting. Yeah, that's no question. Kimball slid to the side to avoid it. Bunting slid on him. Good call by the refs. Keep trying to catch him. I can't get him. They're doing a good job.
1 point game.
Fordham, 7 seconds. Listen, if I'm Fordham, give the ball to number zero and just let him go and put his head down and make a play. And put the onus on the ref to blow the whistle. There's no rim protector in the game for St. Joe's.
For the tie. 7 seconds left and Fordham with a chance to win. Anderson with 3. 2 seconds for the win.
Here we go.